Hey guys, this is Pharaoh 2091, and welcome back to Let's Play Dangan Ronpa. Last time we left off, we began Chapter 5, and a new floor opened up to us, so we came check things out. You know, it had a dojo, a botanical garden, a classroom that was full of bodies and blood. You know, the normal stuff. There also was a locked biology room, a lab, so, can't do anything with that at the moment, so right now we're just gonna give our reports to everybody, like we usually do. Star of Asahina, I guess. Every damn time. Every damn time. Just please, just hurry up already. Sometimes I just think of skipping all this crap. I checked all the windows on the fifth floor, the way Sakura used to. But I didn't have any luck figuring out how to get them open or whatever. They've all got iron plates covering them. There's no way through the fifth floor. And there's no exit on the fifth floor then. Plus, I noticed a little something about the structure of the school, I believe that's what she's saying. What did you notice, Asahina? Did you actually explore the fifth floor, Negi? Huh? Why do you ask? If you would have noticed what the other floors had, but the fifth floor doesn't have. Bathrooms? Something the other floors have, but the fifth floor doesn't? Are you talking about stairs? As I recall, there was no staircase going up on the fifth floor, was there? You mean the fifth floor is the last, or the end? We've finally seen it all. The whole academy. All that's left is to crack the mysteries hidden within. That's no small fish to fry, dude! A bigger fish just means more to eat! Yeah, Asahina's right, I think. We'll be fine, I know it. As long as we all work together, we'll be able to pull something off. I swear we'll get out of this. We have to. Alright. So yeah, I totally forgot to notice that too. Yeah, there's no floors going up, so that means the fifth floor is the final floor. I'm curious to know what's in the biology lab. It's the only room that was sealed on the fifth floor. A biology lab, huh? I wonder what could be inside. Based on what we've seen so far, a creature of some sort, dude. I'm thinking a tyrant type final boss. Resident Evil reference. This isn't a survival horror game, though. In any case, there's no need to think about too hard about it right now. There's no point in wasting your brain power pondering unanswerable questions here. If you're limited mental faculties, so whatever, you would all do well to pay some mind to just how it gets used. Putting the wording aside, you have a good point. There's nothing wrong with how I worded it. Yeah, it is. You're mean about it. Alright. There's a full-on botanical garden on the fifth floor, dude. I found a bunch of interesting stuff there. There's a lot of stuff. There's monster's flower, a chicken coop, and most interesting, there's that shed, dude. Monokuma called it a Monokuma flower. And it's apparently not a good idea to touch it either, so we should probably watch out for that. It's a man-eating flower, dude. This ain't like the ones that come out of pipes. Mario reference. I bet there's that's what those sprinklers are for too, dude. Seems the sprinklers are set to go off automatically every morning at 7:30. Don't forget it, dude. Wouldn't want to get it wet and catch a cold. You'll be fine. They say idiots can't catch colds. Of course not. Idiots don't get wet. You are unnaturally stupid, but not that kind of unnatural. Hey, I'm kind of worried about you, Hagakiri. Do you know what 10 plus 10 is? Oh, come on. Now you've gone too far. Just because I flunked out 3 times doesn't mean I'm that dumb. Well, for argument's sake, I'll answer you. But, what was the question again? Don't worry about it. I got all the answers I need anyway. Oh, Hagakiri. Hey, Tugami, it looks like Fukada wants to say something. And why are you telling me? To keep a zip thing, dude? I forgot about that. Dude, that's almost criminally negligent! Fukawa, you're free to foil up the room with your halitosis if you so desire. It would be the utmost of pleasures, my white knight. And you need not worry, my breath is getting better. That was a tough one. You don't have to worry about me. Besides, my white knight and I are conversing. You stay out of it. So what did you find? I found something interesting in a fifth floor classroom. This. A knife? It's huge! Like something Rambo might carry around. A survival knife, huh? But why would something like this in a classroom? Don't ask me. What do you intend to do to us with that knife, dude? Nothing. I just picked it up, that's all. It's dangerous to just leave it sitting there. And it's 10 times more dangerous in the hands of a homicidal maniac like you, dude! Leave her out of this! She and I are nothing alike! Hey, more importantly, what should we do with it? Obviously, we can't let Kawa keep it, dude, and aside from that, I've got nothing. I wouldn't want something so barbaric anyway. That is a problem. Why don't we give it to Nagi? Huh? To me? Yeah, I think you're a perfect match for that knife, Nags. Well, that was easy. Wait, hold on a second. Don't I get any say? This just goes to show how much they trust you. Quit complaining and take it. That's trust? I feel like I'm just a convenient dumping ground here. Alright, I'm giving a knife to Nagi then. Everyone else is on board with it, I guess. Alright. Got no choice. Suppose I'll just put it in my desk drawer. That's all I have to report. Hey, Fukawa. Ah, is it my breath? I'm sorry for smelling. You made a decent discovery. I'm praising you.
What? My white knight is praising me? That's great. This is a dream. I'm in a dream. For me to be having dreams like this. I'm going crazy. Crazy, seriously crazy. Wait, no, you can't. Not there. Oh, God.
Watching Kawa now is heartbreaking, dude. Yeah, let's just leave it at that. Let's speak to Sugami now. By the way, did you all see the unusual classroom on the fifth floor? No, unusual doesn't quite do it justice. Yeah, you mean that? The scent of human flesh and blood permeating the room. The countless human-shaped outlines. Far more gruesome than any other room we've seen here.
Say what?!
The stench is awful, too. Far beyond any of our murder scenes. Any amalgam or whatever of every imaginable bodily fluid.
It's probably a good thing I didn't go to that room. I feel sick just listening to you.
Anywho, what happened there?
Call it a hunch, but most likely, a great deal of people died in that room.
A bunch of people died there? Hold on, I think I really am going to be sick.
Perhaps that's where mankind's most despairingly maleficent and monstrous malfaction occurred.
What?
It seems you and I are on the same page. Yes, it is possible that the massacre that occurred in that room is a malfaction from a year ago.
The cause of that gruesome scene was the malfaction that happened a year ago?
In other words, the malfaction refers to the mass murder of the Academy students. With that in mind, we can explain why the Academy was forced to shut down.
It makes sense, but damn, that's evil, dude. It's not just evil, it's super terribly evil.
Evil indeed. Hopelessly evil. But in any event, Why hasn't anyone here heard about this? If it was such a huge incident, maybe it really was hidden from the public.
Maybe. Oh, you know what? I forgot to check out some more information from Hagakiri. I'm mistaken there. Yeah.
Oops. There was even real live chickens in a coop, weren't there?
Precisely 5 of them. I love chickens. Let's all raise them together and make fried chicken. But grilled chicken is good too. What should we do? Aha! Let's have them raw. I mean, come on, new experiences.
You can keep your food poison to yourself, dude. Yeah, seriously, raw? Come on, Asahina. And there's one more thing. That shed. Yeah.
So you were bothered by that pickaxe too, Hagakiri?
Pickaxe.
There's a pickaxe in a shed in the garden. With the phrase crazy diamond carved into the handle. Does that ring a bell for anyone?
Crazy diamond? I feel like I've heard that somewhere before.
It's not just a feeling. We have all, in fact, seen those words before.
Huh? Where?
Oh, yeah, right. I remember.
On Uwata's jacket.
Yeah. The back of his jacket said Crazy Diamond, didn't it?
Sure.
You're right, it did. But why would the same phrase be on a pickaxe in the garden?
Maybe Wada stuck into the shed and covered it himself?
We just gained access to the fifth floor today. Maybe Wada brought it with him and Monokuma confiscated it? Either way, it's bugging me. It obviously has some connection with Wada, but what? In any event, it wasn't a pickaxe that caught my eye in the shed.
It wasn't?
I was talking about the lawnmower, dude. I think we might be able to call for help with it.
How would you call for help with a lawnmower?
You still don't get it? We make crop circles.
Oh, God. We use a lawnmower to make crop circles.
Now call for them.
Call for them.
How did...
Hold on a minute, guys. I hate it when I hear stuff when I'm alone at home and I freak the hell out. Okay, how did Hakiri end up like this?
When we first met, he wasn't anything like this.
Yeah, dude, my character hasn't been set in stone at this point yet.
You legitimately depress me.
And with that, it seems like everyone's made their reports.
What now, dude?
Since from here on you guys will be working as my subordinates, there's nothing I like more. I like made clear. Something, I mean, whatever.
Once again, how tall is the ivory tower? You gotta put a hole in that ceiling.
So, what is it you want cleared up? Kyoko Kitagiri's true identity.
What?
Kitagiri's identity? She's Kitagiri, isn't she? And who exactly is Kyoko Kitagiri?
Each and every one of us has a clearly defined reason as to why we were selected to come to the academy. Asahina's a super-duper high school swimmer, Hagakiri's a super-duper high school shaman, Nagi is a super-duper high school luckster. More like unluckster right now, though.
But what about Kitagiri? Is there anyone here who knows?
That's right, she never told us, dude.
She doesn't really like talking about herself.
This isn't a matter of what one likes or dislikes. This is a matter of trust. Can you trust someone who willingly hides our history from you? Start talking, Kitagiri. So to not invite any unnecessary suspicion.
I can't.
What? Why won't you tell us?
I didn't say I wouldn't tell you. I said I can't tell you.
What do you mean, dude?
I don't remember.
Huh?
I have no memory of it.
You have no... You mean you have... amnesia?
Oh, just like freaking 7 in 999.
It appears as though your sense of humor is sorely lacking. It's amusing how unamusing that joke was.
Don't tell me you are serious.
I know you wouldn't believe me.
That's why I didn't say anything. But it doesn't matter to me. Whether you believe me or not, the truth will come out soon enough.
So you intend to maintain your silence until a bitter end then? Is that what this is?
Well, you're best forget about things going your way anymore.
What are you gonna do? Torture me? I wouldn't stoop to something so savage. I'm simply going to restrict your movements so you can't do anything else suspicious.
Restrict my movements?
Hand over your room key.
Her room key? If she gives you that. But it's against the rules to sleep outside a bedroom. She won't be able to sleep.
If she doesn't like it, she can talk. It should be simple enough. She just needs to tell us about herself.
Hold on, what's threatening her going to... Alright, fine.
It seems she's had a change of heart.
You gonna talk now?
Kitagiri approached Tagami, not saying a word. And then... she handed him her key.
You...
Why? Why are you so insistent on your silence?
I told you this once already. Even if I wanted to, I couldn't tell you anything.
Does that mean you were serious, Kitagiri? How about your amnesia?
If you think about it, it's not impossible. If this terrible in this terrible academy, what other terrible stuff happens? A little memory loss ain't so far-fetched.
This terrible academy where only terrible stuff happens? Is that really what this is, though?
Huh?
Can you really say for sure that everything that's happened here is bad?
What do you mean?
I think I've said too much.
With that, Kitagiri turned her back to us and without a word, walked off.
Where do you think you're going?
Don't worry. I won't do anything to get in your way.
And those were her last words.
Kitty Giddy's last words. The sound of the door closing behind Kitty Giddy resonated through the silent cafeteria.
What the heck is she, dude?
I think we might have gone a bit too far. I mean, taking her room key. For her, that was just right. Or better yet, all the pressure excited her, and the more she pushed, the hotter she gets.
Silence, Fukawa. I can still hear you. The sound of your breathing and your heart beating is like a fly in my ear.
You telling her to die? Not that I don't understand the sentiment.
In any event, what does Kitty Giddy plan to do now? And this, the situation, it's exactly the same. Exactly the same as when everyone was getting up on Ugami. And I haven't changed either. I still can't stop them.
Excuse me.
Why she scream?
Whoa! What's up, dude? Why start screaming all of a sudden?
Over there!
Oh, he was just standing there the whole entire time?
Hey, you! How long have you been there? I am unbelievably, unprecedentedly angry!
Angry at what?
At the thief! Sorry to say, but one of you is a thief!
What?
Who stole it? Who stole my treasure?
Your treasure?
Mr. Monokuma believed in you guys, and to have you guys betray that trust... Oh, these days, the world teems with anxiety and anguish. I can understand why people flee to their escapism.
What do you mean, treasure?
Shut up! I hope you all get caught in a whirlpool of unemployment and debt!
And off he goes. What was all that about, dude?
He said someone stole his treasure. Does anyone have any ideas?
It's probably Kyoko Kitagiri's doing.
What?
Who other than her could do something like steal from Monokuma?
Kitagiri stole something from Monokuma? If so, then...
What did she steal? And why?
Okay... Well, I guess we're not really getting an answer. What the hell? Oh man, it's already nighttime.
Uh-oh, we better get out of here.
Looks like this conversation's on pause till tomorrow. Same as Kitty stuff, too.
Putting Monokuma and Kitty Giddy aside, something in the air feels somewhat agitated. I would be extra careful tonight if I were you, and avoid leaving your rooms until morning.
That goes without saying.
Then you're dismissed. I'm going back to my room.
And with that, everyone left the cafeteria and returned to their own rooms. Oh yeah. I better put that knife I got from Fukawa. It should be safe in my desk drawer. Anyway, I wonder if Kage is going to be alright. What is she going to do? Since she can't get into her own room, is there anything I can do for her? Anything I can do? Who knows?
Ooh. Visitor.
I opened my eyes and realized I had fallen asleep at some point. More importantly, someone rang the intercom?
Okay, I guess we can see who it was. Hello?
Oh, Kitty Giddy? I'll be waiting in the dressing room. See you there.
Hold on, Kitty Giddy!
She disappeared into the hall, not paying any of my calls any mind. We just talked about not leaving our rooms tonight, but... I can't not to go either.
Okay. Well, here we are in the dressing room now.
Okay, what do you have to talk to me about?
Sorry for coming by so late.
Don't worry about it. I've gotten used to it.
I see. Now let's get straight to the point. This is something you can't talk about where there are security cameras, isn't it?
Could it be perhaps has something to do with that thing you stole from Monokuma?
Monokuma made a big fuss about it earlier. Something about a treasure being stolen. That was you, wasn't it, Kitty Giddy?
Yes, it was me.
Figured as much. So what'd you take?
This.
A key?
But obviously it wasn't just any key. It had a Monokuma head on at the end of it. I never seen anything like it, quite like it.
Where'd you get that?
I took it from the headmaster's office.
What? You snuck into the headmaster's office?
But I thought the door was locked.
The lock had been broken. What? Ugami. She did it for us.
Ugami did?
You remember her suicide note that what she said? Even in death, retribution will be mine? You're saying Ugami broke down the door to the headmaster's office for our sake? Yes, so that we can uncover the secrets buried in that room.
Ugami did that for us.
She broke the school rules for us. She took one final strike at the academy after she'd sealed her fate. I realized the lock had been broken after yesterday's class trial was over. But I knew that if I went in then, Monokuma would find out right away, so I used you as a decoy.
So you're saying that last night when you told me to go to the data processing room?
Yes, you would attract Monokuma's attention. A second to the headmaster's office using that opening, and through that endeavor is his key.
So that's what this is all about.
Then what was it you told me last night about also something you found there?
Oh yeah, about that person.
Yeah, the girl. Ikusaba, whatever.
Did you learn about this? Learn something about this Mukuro Ikusaba person in the headmaster's office too?
I found a file about her there. I'm still not sure on the details though. But Mukuro Ikusaba is dangerous.
How so?
It's possible she could be the puppet master.
The puppet master?
But didn't Alter Ego say something that there was a pretty high chance that the headmaster was the puppet master?
No, the headmaster is not the puppet master.
Huh?
There's no doubt in my mind, even if I had no proof yet.
She doesn't have any proof, but she can say it with certainty? That's unusual for Kitty Giddy. But assuming the puppet master isn't the headmaster, that makes him or her Mukuro Ikusaba?
In any event, after all this time, we finally got our hands on something big. We can't let this opportunity slip away.
But what exactly is that key open anyway?
I still don't know yet. That's why you're gonna distract Monokuma while I go figure it out.
You're planning on sneaking off somewhere else this time?
That's way too risky! Besides, even if I distract Monokuma, there's no guarantee there's only one puppet master. What if there are multiple puppet masters watching over all of us?
I didn't get caught last night, didn't I?
That could just been coincidence.
There's a possibility that the puppet master can observe us and control Monokuma at the same time.
What?
And that's why I worked last night. I'm not saying you're wrong, though. It is possible it was just a coincidence. But that's exactly why there's merit in trying the same thing one more time. If it works a second time, then my deduction will be all but proven.
I sat in silence and listened to Kitty Giddy as Kitty Giddy continued, speaking in a calm, clear tone.
If the puppet master truly cannot control Monokuma and observe us at the same time, then that gives us an opening. This experiment also serves to make certain of that.
But still, no matter how you put it, it's too dangerous. Think about what will happen if it doesn't work.
That shouldn't be an issue. Remember,
you may investigate the camera freely, no limitations have been placed.
Oh. So there are no limitations what we're allowed to do for the sake of solving mysteries, isn't that right?
Even stealing a key. It's not like I'm breaking any rules.
But do the rules really matter if you piss off the puppet master?
He can kill any one of us, no questions asked!
You bring up a good point. If the plan fails, we'll be able to figure that out too.
Huh?
If things go sour, will the puppet master break his own rules, or will he uphold them to the bitter end? We gain something of value whether the plan fails or succeeds. There's no reason not to go through with it.
But
if you want to accomplish anything, risk is unavoidable. I am well aware of the danger. But if we want answers, we must push forward. Am I wrong?
In that moment, I finally noticed. There wasn't a trace of sorrow or fear in her eyes. Rather, her eyes were locked on the enemy, a mystery that needed to be taken down. And she was smiling.
I will not change my mind. I have no intention of it.
Kitty Giddy reached into her breast pocket and handed me... What's this?
Perhaps you can call it a declaration of my intent.
Don't open it now.
Only open it should something happen to me.
Something? Like what?
It's just a precaution. On the off chance something does happen to me, I don't want to die in vain. Please, I want you to take it.
Fine, I'll take it, but that's all. As soon as this is done, I'm giving it back. Mark my words.
Yes, of course. And one final thing. I'd like you to keep this a secret from the others, at least for now.
Because it'll be harder to keep it from the pub master?
That's one reason.
There are other reasons?
So?
Never mind. It's not important. I can't forget something like that so easily. Alright then, let's get started. I'm counting on you, Nikki.
I just need to distract Monokuma.
Alright, I'll try.
I'll go on ahead then. You take care of things here.
She left with nothing but a curt, cold goodbye, as she always did.
She left with a brisk, determined gait, and as she always did.
The only thing different was a feeling of uncertainty welling up inside my chest as I watched her shrink into the distance.
No, it'll be fine. It'll be fine. I mean, it's Kitty Giddy, after all.
I mumbled to myself, trying to loosen some of the tension, and then I got to work.
Alright, let's rock. Monokuma, you're watching, aren't you? I like to talk. Show yourself!
Man, this video is going on for way too long, but, you know, hey, whatever. A short time later...
Monokuma, well, if that ain't a rare sight, you hardly ever call me yourself, Nagi. By the way, Nagi,
what?
What were you and Kitty-Gitty doing alone in the bath in the middle of the night? Were things getting steamy? Steamy and wet, and then
remove the comply with the ESRB content regulations.
Am I right? It's a secret then. Aww. That's okay though. Unlike you, Nangi, baths don't really do much for me. I like to keep my surveillance clean and wholesome. No R ratings here.
Is that why there aren't any cameras in the bath?
Bingo! I'm betting the real reason you didn't put them in there was because of steam with fogged lenses.
That's my bingo.
Whatever, what do you want? What'd you bring me all the way out here for?
Well, there's something I'd like to know.
Whether I'm a boy girl or a boy bear or a girl bear? Bears don't have genders.
Actually, yeah, they do.
Seriously? Then, what does that make me? What am I?
Oh no, I'll just get depressed if I think about it too hard.
What was he wanting to ask, Nagi?
What you said earlier about someone stealing your treasure, what exactly did you have stolen?
I hope I'm misinterpreting here, and yet you didn't call me all the way here just to ask me that. I'm shocked! 100 megavolts shocked! Don't you have anything more important to ask, like how I harvest honey or what I'm like in heat? Unbelievable. Are all pubescent boys as pitifully boring as you? Fine, I'll tell you, this trip isn't a total waste. A key and a blankety blankety blank. There, happy?
Blankety blankety blank?
Use your head, it means I'm not telling you.
I'd like to know what's in that head of yours that made you think calling me for this was a good idea.
Next time you waste my time for something so stupid, I'll cut it open and find out for myself.
And with that, Monokuma vanished.
Phew.
That should be sufficient enough for a distraction. And that's all that's left for me to do is believe in Kitty Giddy and wait for her to return safely. There's nothing to worry about. It's Kitty Giddy. Right? I returned to my room and fell asleep right away, trying to escape from my lingering uncertainty. Act 16. Oh, jeez. Oh, TV. Monokuma Theater, Advert Edition. This game is brought to you by Spike Company Limited. Okay. What? Oh no! It crashed! I honestly do not remember this happening. I really think it crashed. Well. That happened. Oh, wait. What the? Act 16. What the hell just happened here? This is the era of a ninja. Samurai are a thing of the past. By the way, why am I getting an offer? I'm so confused. I pressed every button for a long time. Nothing happened. Now all of a sudden it happened. Okay, I'll buy it anyway, though. I'll buy two copies. Okay, I do not remember that happening last time I played this game. Or maybe it's been a little while. 30 minutes? Man, I gotta stop this video. Probably here. Good morning! Shut up! Alright, my arms and legs feel heavy. Is it because I woke up so late? In any case, I gotta get to the cafeteria. Nope, we'll do that in the next episode, and yeah, very long episode. I know what I probably should have done is cut it off right before I answered a door. I just didn't think it was going to take that long. Oh well, long episode. Try to enjoy it if you can. So, as usual, thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys next time for Let's Play Dangan Ronpa. I'll see you guys later.